噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔！What's up, sons? It's Blind Rod with Son of a Tech once again, and today we're going to be covering the hash rate prediction for the RTX 3080 Ti. With a huge caveat, they're probably going to go ahead and put that block that they did on the 3060 on the 3080 Ti. For Ethereum, of course. So we'll do a couple other projections and predictions outside of Ethereum, but for today we're going to focus on Ethereum. We've been deathly accurate with these predictions in the past, like with the 6700 XT, of course, and we have a lot of new leaks that are giving us all the details we need to make this prediction. But before we get into it, here's a word from our sponsor. Today's sponsor is CDK Deals. To get great deals on Windows 10 Pro keys, check out the links in the description. To activate, it's as simple as going to cdkdeals.com using the link in the description and then searching for Windows 10 Pro. From here, you just need to click Buy Now. Then you can sign up for a quick and easy account. Don't forget to type in your promo code, which is SOT20, and click Submit Order. From here, you can pay with FastPay, PayPal, credit card, etc. Once you have completed your purchase, head on over to the User Center. Once processing is complete, you will be able to get your key to activate Windows. Your key will be located in your account under My Purchased Orders. You will click View Keys and Codes, click Get the Key, and then you will copy the code. Next, head on over to Windows, search in Cortana for Activation Settings, click on Change Product Key, and use Control V to paste the code into the box. Click Next, then click Activate, and your copy of Windows will be activated. No more pesky watermark. To get 20% off your Windows 10 Pro purchase, don't forget to check out the affiliate link down in the description and use promo code SOT20 when signing up. Welcome back. So once again, we got to clarify that this is probably not going to matter because it will be blocked at least until NVIDIA accidentally leaks another driver to allow us to mine with the 3080 Ti. On some Ethereum. That being said, let's go ahead and get into the numbers. So first things first, as you can see here, we have the leak up from WCCF Tech, and we have basically this slot column here all the way almost to the end. The 3090 is on one side and the 3080 is on the other side. And we have kind of our predictions. We have question marks for the things they're not sure about, and then, of course, no question marks for the things that they're pretty confident on. So a 1365 megahertz base clock with a 1665 megahertz boost clock. That is a little bit lower than both the 3080 and the 3090, which is interesting. So that could be, of course, a reference model. We'll have to see, you know, what happens here, especially with the shortage. I'm not sure how many reference models versus third parties are going to be released and all of that. It could be pretty difficult to determine. Now, they went with a 12 gigabytes of GDDR6. As opposed to the 10 on the 3080. And this allowed them to basically have a 384-bit bus similar to the 3090, meaning this will definitely be much better than the 3080 at mining if it's true. This is pretty cool. There's no question mark next to it, so we're pretty positive that that should be pretty awesome. Now, when we do our predictions, we base it off of the bandwidth, right? And that's just going to be a calculation between the bus width and, of course, the memory speed. The memory speed is a little higher on the RTX 3090 as reported. So it does take that memory performance down from 936 gigabits per second to 912 gigabits per second. So if we put that into a percentage calculator, well, so what we did here is we basically took the hash rate of the 3080 and we went ahead and calculated it out for the percentage calculator, because this memory speed is going to be closer to the 3080 than it is going to be to the 3090, meaning that I wanted to use the 3080 as the reference. So basically we took the bus width of the 3080, which is that 760, and we found what the percentage number is going to be for, of course, the 3080 Ti. So then after we got the percentage count, we just said, what is 120% of 97? 97 being the hash rate of the RTX 3080. This comes out to 116 mega hash a second. So that will be my prediction, is that we should be around 116 mega hash a second. If we go back to the chart, you will also see that the power consumption should be around the RTX 3080 at 320 watts, as opposed to the 3090, which is at 350 watts. Because the clock does appear to be lower or about the same, it's either going to be lower or the same as the RTX 3080 on the core, we should be able to downclock that using the absolute core clock that we talked about in yesterday's video, to go ahead and get the absolute core clock down on the 3080 Ti in theory, meaning that we would be around the same power consumption of 207 watts. So if we go over to what to mine now and we plug that into ETHash and ETHash 4G at 116 mega hash a second at 207 watts, and then we take a look at a profitability, we would have revenue of $13.08 a day on Ethereum, with a in pocket after 10 cents a kilowatt hour, which is the national average for the United States, you would make $12.58 a day. Now, if you had that 3080 Ti on Ethereum Classic right now, which is super pumping, you would have a revenue of $14.17 a day, with profit of $13.68 a day. Now, if we wanted to pay that off before, of course, we have the projection of the end of Ethereum mining, provided, you know, we don't think Ethereum Classic is going to maintain its profitability, then from the ETH all core devs, we would want to be done with paying off our cards by the end of 2021. So that's going to be about 7 months. So to make a quick calculation, let's just go ahead and run that out for us. We would have 7 times 30, just to be averaged. So we would want to pay it off in 210 days after power times 1258. You would want to pay no more than $2,641.80 if the card was available today and you could purchase it and get it mining right now. Okie dokie, so I hope that was helpful. I like to go over these things and show you guys. This is basically my thought process when buying equipment, how it functions. This is how I calculate predictions on what GPUs might perform at, so I can determine how many I may want to try to get my hands on. Of course, in the current market, it's going to be nearly impossible to find any GPU. And once again, I'll just remind you, you get what you get and you don't throw a fit. If you can get anything that's going to pay itself off within 210 days per the all core devs, then you should be safe and feel warm and fuzzy safe, you know. But if you want to take a risk and hope that ETC stays strong, even though I don't know about that. We have a video coming out about that tomorrow, okay? So hit the notification bell, hit the sub. We'll talk about Ethereum Classic tomorrow. I will see you next Tuesday. If you enjoyed this content, you can check out more crypto content on this playlist up here. Or, of course, go ahead and subscribe for more in the future. Adios.